Hello everyone, and thank you for choosing to read my hub. Today we're going to make a chicken pot pie recipe that I found on allrecipes.com. These are just the ingredients that I choose to use. A pack of boneless, skinless chicken breast. I'm going to use a 14-ounce can of chicken broth, a 8.5-ounce can of peas and carrots, and a 11-ounce can of just golden sweet kernel corn. I'm going to use a 1/2 cup of onion to make the sauce that goes inside the chicken pot pie. Right now I'm going to cut up and go ahead and cook all the chicken. Preemptively, I've went ahead and heated up my oven. I'm going to go up to 425 to brown the crust. Okay, so I rinsed and cut off the excess fat of about 2 pounds of boneless, skinless chicken breast. I'm going to cook it on medium heat inside my big pan I have here. Have about 1/2 cup of onion that I'm going to make the sauce with. It goes with flour and milk and a little bit of chicken broth. So let's go ahead and slide that in and get to browning up this meat and cooking it. And then we're going to add our peas and carrots and corn to it. Then we're just going to let it chill out so we can make our sauce on the side. Temperature's doing good. We're up to 185 degrees so far. Got quite a ways to go though. So let's go ahead and throw this in the pan. Okay, just add a little bit of oil. Make sure it's really hot. Make sure whenever you're dropping your meat into it, the oil doesn't splash up and burn you. Let's go ahead and brown this up and tenderize it, and then let's add our vegetables to it. Alrighty, we got our chicken cooked up. Gonna drain and throw in our can of peas and carrots, and throw in our can of corn. I like more corn in mine. It's optional. You can do whatever you want. And then I'm gonna hit it with about 2 cups of water and keep everything moist and kind of let that boil back off. As it's boiling, it's gonna soften everything into a nice little mixture here. So I'm gonna keep it on about medium heat and just kind of let it boil out and get rid of some of that water. And now we can begin on our sauce. I'm gonna go ahead and let those onions cook up and soften up. And then we're just going to keep adding stuff to it. I'll show you how it goes. Okay, so we're boiling this back down, back to where it come from. Going to get rid of all the water, keeping it moist. And then this here, we're just adding butter and onions. We're just going to cook them down until they're super soft and translucent. And then we're going to add some milk, flour, and chicken broth. I usually make more sauce than what it calls for, because I want to make sure and completely fill up that pie pan and be able to cover it with my my two pies. Okay, so this next part's gonna be a little hard to film, so I'm just gonna have to tell you what I'm doing and then do it. Boiled out about 2/3 of my water, so I got about 1/3 left in there. Just I've completely reduced the heat, turned it off. That's just gonna kinda sit and mellow out. The corn's good and soft, everything's kinda meshing together. The water actually turned into like a chicken broth, so that's really good. This here, got my onions going. They're kinda browning up a little bit, good and soft. Kind of sauteing in the butter there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go milk, I'm going to go chicken broth, and I'm going to go flour. I'm going to do all that consecutively. I'm going to fill up about 1/2 of this pot with the what's called the cream sauce. So that's what we need to do. Okay, so we're done with the sauce. On this sauce, unlike my tomato soup sauce, I usually leave it more liquid than anything, because whenever you hit it with 425 on 2 layers of pie crust, a lot of this liquid is going to get sucked up in there and kind of evaporate. So to keep your pot pie from getting dry, you need to really go heavy with the chicken broth and the milk, and go kind of light with the flour. See, this is still, you know, really, really thin, but it's going to be okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to drain all this into here. I don't have very much liquid this time because it all kind of boiled out. Your pie crust, you pull them right out of the freezer and they pop out pretty good, but don't let them thaw out too much because they get too soft and then they'll start breaking apart. You can see this one's still pretty solid and frozen. I got a 9-inch pie pan. I've already got one sitting in here. I'm going to put my chicken and vegetables inside here now. Then I'm going to fill it up with sauce, and then I'm going to add this to the top, and then we'll slide it in the oven. As you can see, that just barely does fit in there in a 9-inch pan. So now let's fill it up with sauce and top it with the other one. Okay, so maybe that's just a little bit too much sauce, but I kind of made a little oops, added a little bit too much sauce to my pan, and I actually, as I was making this video, I let it sit on the heat just a little bit too long, so it's a little bit thicker than I wanted, but we'll just put the top on it, slide it in the oven, and it's still going to eat pretty good, so we're not too worried about that. It's going to be all right. Just a little bit, it's going to be a little bit drier than I usually like it. Okay, so there we go. Got it on 425. We're going to go for about 30 minutes, but I would advise to keep a really close eye on it because you can brown it really quickly. So just keep a close eye, but we're going to try and go for 30 minutes. Personally, I'm probably going to set my timer for only 20 and just keep an eye on it after that. So there you go, guys. A very healthy chicken pot pie recipe. Like I said, 20 minutes is about all I do. 425 on the middle rack. Browns it up quite nicely. It's good to go. As you've seen, not a whole lot to this. Very nutritious. Cooked with real chicken, unlike what is inside the fast food restaurants with the fake processed chicken. So, I think about the worst thing in this recipe is probably the flour and the milk or something. But, you know, nice 9-inch pan of chicken pot pie. Great to feed a family of four. I recommend doing two if you feed more than four. That actually came out pretty good this time. Still a lot of moisture in the bottom of it. So just thought I'd tell you, it's still pretty good. I don't add salt and pepper. I let whoever eats it, if they want to add salt and pepper, they can. But the recipe says to do it with salt and pepper.
So there you go.
Hope you enjoy it. Thank you for reading my hub. Thank you for watching my video. And check back for future recipes. We'll see you guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.